In Iceland, something unusual appears to be occurring at a large volcano which few people have ever heard of. Located in the center of the country, far away from the erupting Reykjanes volcano, is a massive Hofsjökull ice sheet. Underneath this ice sheet is a massive volcano which goes by the same name, including a sizable volcanic caldera that is buried by up to 710 meters or 2,329 feet thick of glacial ice. Since 2019, the Hofsjökull volcano has been the site of an ever-increasing number of earthquakes year over year, with these quakes on track to reach record levels by the end of this year. In only 5 years, Hofsjökull, which averaged only 8.2 earthquakes per year beforehand, has seen a 767% increase in the rate of volcano tectonic earthquakes that have struck, leading some to speculate that this volcano is beginning to reactivate. If true, this would be quite remarkable for what is considered to be one of the, if not the, least active young volcano in the country. So, why exactly are these quakes occurring? Before I can answer this question, we must first understand the general structure of the Hofsjökull volcano. The Hofsjökull volcano consists of two central edifices, two rift zones, and a series of flank vents outside of the areas covered by its 925 square kilometers of glaciers. The larger of the two edifices has been active for at least 800,000 years and is composed of numerous low-viscosity basalt lava flows, while the popular tourist attraction to the southwest known as Kerlingarfjöll formed out of viscous rhyolite lava flows between 350,000 and 68,000 years ago. Neither of these central volcanic edifices, which rise as much as a kilometer above the surrounding landscape, have been the site of a volcanic eruption since the Holocene epoch began in 9700 BCE. However, after significant glacial retreat occurred between 9700 BCE and 6200 BCE, five small volcanic eruptions occurred, with a sixth larger eruption representing its latest eruption occurring in 3750 BCE. These eruptions covered a combined area of 57.46 square kilometers and a layer of basaltic lava, all of which was essentially completely effusive in nature since no ash layers have been found near their source vents. With this in mind, let us take a look at where earthquakes have generally struck between 2010 and 2018. There are three large clusters of activity, each of which is linked to a known set of geothermal features. As heated groundwater moves through adjacent faults, it can lubricate them and make them more likely to slip, hence the normal activity at this volcano. Yet, since 2019, the location of earthquakes has changed, with quakes now largely occurring in a zone of activity adjacent to the Hofsjökull glacier. These quakes are larger magnitude than is typical, are occurring at increased rates where essentially none struck before, and are striking at deeper depths than is typical. Since the nearby Havel GPS station seemingly indicates a 3.5 mm uplift more than other further away stations, does this mean that magma is intruding underneath the volcano? This is a potential possibility, although if a magmatic intrusion was to be ongoing, it would be small in volume and occurring at around 30 kilometers depth in the deepest parts of the regional crust. The earthquakes in this case would simply be caused by overlying strain release on faults closest to the magmatic uplift. However, there is a second possibility that I deem to be far more likely, and I base my evidence for this on a small jökulhlaup associated with a strong sulfur smell that was observed in 2013. That sulfur odor was caused by direct interaction of Hofsjökull's fumaroles and hot springs underneath its thick ice sheet interacting with meltwater. These gases became more likely to be included in jökulhlaups since the area's ice sheets have decreased in both extent and thickness during the last 40 years. As a result, less pressure is placed on underlying rock, making it easier for gases and hydrothermal fluids to ascend to the surface. I thus believe that these new quakes represent some unknown threshold being passed around 2019 due to a decrease in pressure caused by declining ice sheets. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Mr. Black, for supporting this YouTube channel.